Hey everyone, my name is GameStash, and welcome to this tutorial about the use of the Enigma machine on WOLFPACK. Before I start the video, I just wanted to thank all of you for the amazing support I got on my previous video about setting up the Torpedo data computer. I've received a number of questions and a lot of compliments, and I'm really thankful for that. If you're interested, you can check it out. There's a link on screen. In this video, I will go over how you and your friends can use the Enigma in WOLFPACK. I will first go over how the machine works in BASIC, then I'll describe the errors I've discovered in the manual as described by the creators of the game, and finally, I will give you a secure way to use the Enigma between yourself and friends in a different submarine. The Enigma is a type of encryption. Encryption is what is used to take a message and send it securely to a receiver, so that only the sender and receiver can understand the message. You may have used one of these yourself in school to send a message to your friends. One example of such an encryption is taking the alphabet and shifting every letter to the next one. A becomes a B, B becomes a C, etc. The message hello would then be IFMMP. This type of encryption is called Caesar cipher and was used by the Romans. The Enigma uses three rotor wheels. Each can be set to one letter of the alphabet. When typing a message, these rotor wheels will turn. This lets the message seem even more random, and, more specifically, typing a letter over and over will result in a different encrypted letter every time. Moreover, in the original Enigma machine, the rotors could be switched around, and these plugs could be switched, resulting in a whopping 158 quintillion possible settings. In WOLFPACK, you can only change the three rotors. Originally in World War II, officers would be handed a sheet that instructs them for each day how to set up the Enigma. This is of course not possible for the game of WOLFPACK. Therefore, the manual tells you to do the following. Pick a public key setting for the Enigma and pick a private key. Use the public key to encrypt your private key. Use your private key to encrypt your secret message. Now, send the public key, the encrypted key, and the encrypted message through the telegraph. Then, the receiving submarine must use the public key on the encrypted private key to get the private key. The private key is then used to decipher the message. However, this method will not ensure security, because anyone that has an Enigma can now decipher your private key and read the message. Therefore, the use of an extra private key does not make any sense. Come to think of it, encrypting your message is not needed at all, because there is no one out there that can receive, besides your own submarine and maybe some friends you're playing with. It would be cool if destroyers were player controlled. Then it would make sense to encrypt messages. So if you want to send messages, just use the telegraph system. But if you still want to secretly send messages, here is how. First, we have to make sure you and the receiver can exchange messages. Make sure the radio sender and receiver are tuned correctly. For example, if the first submarine sends its message on channel 1, the second submarine must receive on channel 1. The setup on screen will work. Now, communicate a key to the other crew and make sure you do this in a secure way. You can do this through Discord or Steam. Set the rotors to the ones you've agreed on and type your message. Be sure to write down which letters light up on the Enigma. Transfer the encrypted message over the telegraph. You do this by simply pressing the key on your keyboard when using the telegraph. The receiver then has to write down the received code and type it on the Enigma, and he will get the original message back. I hope this video has helped you to make better use of the Enigma. If you have any ideas on how to use the Enigma that I haven't thought of, please leave them in the comments below. Also, if you've enjoyed this video, why not subscribe to my channel? It would really mean a lot to me. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.